Good afternoon, students. Welcome to the most awaited event, the grand finale of Young Asian Entrepreneurial Challenge 2020. Who said that age matters? If age mattered, then how would have George Matthews, the founder of Teal, which is a manufacturer of commercial drones, raised a seed funding of $2.8 million? His age, if you ask about his age, dear students, he just turned 18 this year. Who said big investment matters? To your surprise, the founder of Wow Momos, Mr. Sagar Daryani, started his venture with merely 30,000 rupees. And I must tell you that today his company is worth more than rupees 560 crores. Dear friends, when they say an idea can change your life, in today's world, 2020, they surely mean it. It can. Asian Business School not only focuses on accelerating your academic excellence, but also tries to foster creative thinking and business-making attitude amongst all. With the same vision, Young Asian Entrepreneurial Challenge 2020 was announced, where we invited your big ideas that can be shaped further to help you be an entrepreneur of future. I am thrilled to say that this, despite being 100% virtual, the kind of energy and zeal that each one of you has shown in crafting the business plan was simply breathtaking. This challenge was organized by the Entrepreneurship Development and Incubation Center, the EDIC, which aims to enable the students to be more creative and self-confident in taking rational risks in starting an enterprise and encourages innovative business startups and facilitates them through research and consultancy. This business plan challenge invited creative ideas and plans which could help you become a job provider rather than job seeker in future. The moment we announced this competition, we started getting a lot of queries, a lot of registrations, write-ups, inputs, questions from all of you that clearly reflected the quality and attitude of this bundle of talent that we have with us today. The event began a couple of months back, where almost around 100 students started putting up an effort to come up together to share their business ideas. Thereafter, all those students presented their ideas in virtual mode in front of experts at Asian Business School, who scrutinized their business plans in detail. As announced earlier, the winner of this grand event, my friends, I want to fetch your attention here because this is the most important aspect which you all were looking for. I will repeat my lines again. As announced earlier, the winner of this grand event would be surely a lucky one as he or she grabs a fortune today. At least I would say so. That is an Apple MacBook. So all the techies out there get very excited. Direct entry into the top five in the grand finale of the annual EDIC business plan competition. For those of you who don't know, Entrepreneurship Development and Incubation Center of Asian Business School offers rupees 5 lakhs as seed funding to the best business plan. So the winner of today's event shall gain an automatic entry in the grand finale of the event and be one of the 5 participants there. And dear students, last but not the least, the winner of today's event will get an interview coverage in the Noida Radio. He or she will be awarded a glittering trophy and a certificate for the same as well. Though the winner would be one, but I'd like to congratulate each one of you for an exemplary performance and participation with which you presented your business ideas. As we invited your big ideas, how could the finale be ordinary? So here we have with us our guest of honor, Mr. Aman Gupta, co-founder and CMO at Boat Lifestyle, who himself is a quintessential example of a successful entrepreneur. An alumnus of the Indian School of Business, IBS, he was a chartered accountant at 21. The customary work stints with global brands followed by where he went on to work with Citibank, KPMG, and JBL as sales director. This electric work experience speeded his decision to build up a brand of his own. Sensing the need to smart, efficient, stylish, and durable mobile wearables and hearables, Mr. Aman teamed up with Mr. Sameer Mehta to launch Boat in 2016. The consumer electronics space in India logged products designed while keeping India use cases in mind. Given factors such as dust and heat, tropical weather, etc., there was a huge gap in the market for products designed to be durable and resistant to these factors while also appealing to the Indian customers' aesthetic responsibilities and sensibilities. Boat's products try to address this gap through a strong focus on products, design, and technology. Over the years, Mr. Gupta has gained a lot of recognition in the industry and has earned several accolades, such as Business World's Hottest Young Entrepreneur of 2019 and India's Entrepreneur of the Year 2020 in Product and Manufacturing Business. We welcome you, sir, to this event. Amongst us, we also have our internal team on the dais who have very closely analyzed and brainstormed to find the best ideas amongst the total of more than 120 ideas received. We have amongst us Dr. Anubhuti Dwivedi, Dean Academics and Chairperson EDIC, Mr. Vinod Dhar, and Ms. Veenu Arora, Member EDIC. Without waiting any further, I would like to request our esteemed guest to share his valuable experiences and knowledge with our students.
Hi, thank you for the introduction. That was so nice of you. And hello, students. Hi, faculty members. Hi, professors, dean, everyone. I'll start with the presentation straight up. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir, you're
visible to us. All right. Can you see the screen?
Yes, it is visible.
All right, great. So I'll start with the company first. This is Boat, and my PR, as usual, gives a big introduction about me first. So yeah, I'm an accountant by profession, a chartered accountant. Then I did my MBA finance from ISB. Then I worked with KPMG, Citibank. So all finance, all everywhere. And this is an important slide I wanted to show to you guys that, you know, on education, I'm a finance guy. And then I moved into sales and marketing. And today, for last 4 years, we started Boat, and this is where we are. I'll come back to this slide, right? So this is what they said, you know, when you're doing an education, like you remember, we all of us know Three Idiots, right? What Three Idiots said, ki boss success ke piche mat bhago. Jo aapka passion hai, uske piche bhago. So that is what lied, you know, that is what made me do marketing, that is what made me do gadgets, that is what made me do lifestyle products, because finance was something which I studied and I didn't, you know, it was more of, to be frank to everyone, it was more of a pressure from the family. Wo hota hai na ki ya to CA kar lo, ya engineer ban jao, ya doctor ban jao. So one of those lines was that, you know, main CA karunga aur maine CA kar li. So, but, you know, eventually it was a calling that I never liked finance, and I eventually followed my passion. My passion was into gadgets. My passion was into lifestyle electronics, was into brand building, and that is what brought me into Boat. So everybody, you know, there's a lot of noise which is around. You know, as students, you'll all hear a lot of people saying, you know, do this, do that. You're not good for this, good for that. There's nothing different about you. What will you do differently? Or, you know, this. So when we were entering this space, people said that ye commoditized space hai, isme mat jao, apna SWOT analysis banao, you guys don't know anything about marketing, how can you sell a lifestyle brand? Those were that was the questions being asked to us, to me and Sameer, that boss, you know, you guys know nothing, how can you do something here? So this is what we did. This is a story about us. You know, we started off in 2016. We did some innovative marketing. We signed our first brand ambassador, Hardik Pandya. When we signed him up 2017, he was no one. He was nobody knew him as any brand. You know, no brand had signed him up, and he was also new in this in the field of cricket. 2017, we started growing from 16 to 17 to 18. 2018, we got institutional funding. We got Fireside Ventures as our institutional investor. We did a record sales of 200 crores that time. And then 2019, last year, we had some more brand ambassadors and marketing who joined us. The product started selling well. And now we have a lot of brand ambassadors and collaborations which work for us. 2020, again, the brand started going up. And if you see the sales from 2016 to 2020, financial year 2020, we recorded sales of 1,000 crores as our turnover, which is huge in this industry. In 4 years, we are one of the fastest growing brands in the country. I can't hear the claps, but I'm sure you must be. Thank you. So this we've done. Let me give you an overview of the brand. Our brand is a reflection of our personality. We are bold without being in your face. We are innovative in a manner that simplifies rather than complicates. We are young without being immature, and we are witty without being boorish. That's what BOAT is. Today, you know, by FY20, we've sold around 11 million units. 11 million means more than a crore units. India's population is 100 crores, 130 crores, and we've already sold to 1% of the population. It's not about where you've reached. It's all about how far you can go. What's the brand philosophy? We are a challenger brand. When we entered, there were brands like Sennheiser, Sony, Philips, Samsung, JBL, Bose, Skullcandy. So, you know, there was those, you know, people say that you should enter a space, develop something which is unique. I would say that if you have some right ideas, if you've got a right product, you can be a challenger to anybody. You know, your institute is a challenger to a lot of big institutes. So you guys also have it in you to be a challenger. Don't think that only Goliaths can rule this world. Davids were the one who beat Goliaths eventually, right? So be a disruptor, be a challenger, go for the kill. That's what I would say. So we call ourselves dynamic disruptors. We've created products that are significantly superior to incumbents. We've created drama into a category which was uninspiring communication. We are the choice of people because we are dynamic disruptors. So we have challenged our way in 4 years. You know, IDC is one of the biggest agency to give market share for a lot of mobile players, to a lot of hearable brands, to wearable brands. So IDC named us number one in India in quarter one 2020. This is the third quarter running. We've been number one. We've beaten the likes of Samsung, Realme, Xiaomi, Sony, JBL. Everybody's, you know, the Samsung means Samsung is acquired JBL. Samsung already has a lot of brands like JBL inside. So you know, nothing is far away. If you guys dream big, if you guys dream of disrupting the world, you can. So this is the brand. You know, we were edgy, we were liberating, we were quirky. The archetype is more of a explorer brand archetype. You must have studied or you will study about brand archetypes. The brand purpose is to enable people to pursue their passions with uninhibited spirit. That's the brand purpose. I'm sure you guys know all about you know, how brands work, what are the archetypes, what are the purpose, and or you'll learn more about it. So our brand, you know, in India, they say that there are three things which sell well: cricket, Bollywood, and music. And, you know, we've tried to incorporate a lot of brand ambassadors who help us sell the brand to give the message of what BOATheads are. So we call the first one as Glamour of the Stars, where we have Kiara Advani as Kartik Aaryan as the BOATheads representing us. In Sound of the Champions, we've got Shikhar, Prithvi, you know, literally the whole team, Hardik, KL, Shreyas, Rishabh, everybody as the Sound of the Champions. You know, they all promote BOAT, they all love BOAT, that's why they are with us. In the Soul of the Musicians, we've got Nezi and Neha Kakkar, one of the most liked. Neha Kakkar is one of the most liked musicians in India today. She's got a following of around 40 million. Nezi is one of the Gully Boy artists. The Gully Boy movie was based on him. So Nezi is one of the, we call it Soul of the Musicians. That's what we are. So if you see here, these are the top of, these are the influencers and the associations we've done. We do a lot of IPL, we do Sunburn. Sunburn, I'm sure all of you go to Sunburn. It's a music festival, which is very famous in India. You know what happened exactly was, there was a cultural shift happening. We turned audio wear from consumer electronics to pieces of fashion statement. You know, today you wear shirts, you wear clothes which you like, right? Everybody wears what they want to wear. What we did here was we wanted headphones to be one of those products where people wear headphones as style statements. People wear headphones as something which is a part of their lifestyle. And we converted a category which was a commoditized category of consumer electronics into a fashionable electronic category. So we work with designers. We do Lakme Fashion Week. We work with Kunal Raval. He's a very renowned designer. We make headphones, which are designed by him. We do Sunburn. We do events like, we had Wiz Khalifa. We had Alan Walker, Yellow Claw. You know, all these guys came in. So the reason we do all this is to bring out the style, the vibe, and the association Boat has with a lot of celebs. We do a lot of print campaigns. I don't know whether some of you saw some print campaigns we did. We took some jackets. We tried to promote them. And this is the type of vibe which we have. This is the type of brand which we've created. Moving on, where do we play? If you look at the internet users, by the end of 2020, it's going to be 800 million. We are a market which is at the cusp of digital explosion, right? I'll tell you a small example. Today, work from home, workout from home, cinema at home, study at home, learn at home. If all of us are connected, so imagine the potential which a category like audio headphones has today, right? There are so many people. Today, you can't watch some of the serials, some of the Netflix channels, some of the OTT content from Netflix or Prime Video. Can you watch that content without headphones? The content is such that you cannot even watch it at home without pairing your personal listening devices. So the market is changing. Everybody changes, and you guys, we all are changing. And if with the time you don't change, the consumers change you. This is the market which potential to grow, where it is. So this is where we are, trying to build, building sound empire to ourselves. As I said, in IDC, we were number one. Our products are named for the consumers we have. People say India ko base pasand hai. Ek movie mein nahi tha, India baby ko base pasand hai. So that's actually true. India loves base. So we cater to a category of Indians, which is 90% of India though, which likes base. So we cater to the base heavy country, India, with products which are tuned to India. This is what our products were. Our products are rated among the best. If you go to Flipkart, Amazon, Snapdeal, we were rated among the best products. We work very closely with technology players like Dolby, Everlock, Google, Amazon, Qualcomm. Online players are dominated. This is the sales by channel which we have. This is our team, small team. I won't bore you with all these names and numbers. This is what we've done. These are the lifestyle of Boathead. We've won a lot of awards, categories. Sachin Bansal from Flipkart is an investor in our company. Innovan Capital, which is a Singapore government, Temasek-based government entity, which is backing us. Kaval, who's an equity investor, has invested in Yoga Bar, Paper Boat, Licious, Pipabella, a lot of products. So small slide that, employees love us. We've given employees ESOPs. This is how you guys, if you look at entrepreneurship, you should also look at this, that the ecosystem, wo ek Shah Rukh Khan ka dialogue nahi tha, that agar sari kainat tumhe koshish karti hai pura karne ke liye, agar tum kuch chahte ho toh, there was something like that, right? So you have to have your ecosystem which loves you. Your employees are your partners. They love you. They are shareholders. They own the company, right? Retailers, we help them sell more. Investors, we don't burn money. We earn money. We're a profitable company. Our head Boatheads, our consumers love us. Our Boatheads love us. This is what we are. So in a category, we created aspiration. All your budding entrepreneurs, I would say, make that ecosystem where people recognize you. People talk to you about your product or the brand or the category you are getting into. Your employees, your teachers, your professors who can tell you about a lot of things, That ecosystem should come into play to help you grow more. This is another video which I wanted to show. If that comes in, then that will show the perception and the vibe of Boat. This is it. I have run through my presentation because I wanted to spend more time on questions and not on the journey which we have done. It's been an incredible ride, right? And you've all sailed through the ultimate Boat experience, is what I would say. Thank you so much for listening to me. And I'll open the floor to the video and then the questions post that.
It could be the first match as a teenager, or the 100th of a season player. It could be the comfort of the home ground, or the uncertainty of foreign pitches. The nerves, the jitters, the doubt, they somehow find a way in. Voices that doubt your sincerity, your hard work. With those tattoos and crazy hair, is he serious enough? The doubts that bring down your faith. In these doubtful moments, you do what you gotta do. Listen to what matters. I'm KL Rahul, and I'm a boathead.
Cheers to entrepreneurs. Cheers to the spirit of entrepreneurship.
Definitely so. Thank you so much for sharing such invaluable thoughts of yours and giving confidence to our students that if they have an idea, they definitely can earn that idea and make it practically possible. As you said, our students are really very excited and they have lots of questions for you. The very first question is that what, according to you, is the key skill for becoming an entrepreneur?
I think the answer is that, you know, you need to have that that passion to do it. And the, you know, there will, as I said in the first slide, that's the reason I wanted to show you that slide. That, you know, there'll be a lot of people saying a lot of things. There'll be a lot of different noises you'll hear from here and there. But if you have it in you, if you think your idea is successful, I would say, you know, better try than cry. Because, you know, if you don't do it, somebody else will do it. So might as well give it a shot. Today, India is in the best possible position where the government is also encouraging, Indians to be Atmanirbhar Indians, to be vocal for local, right? So Indian brands, Indian tech, Indian apps, Indian resources. You know, today we are in the best position to fight it out with global brands, with people who, you know, we've got it. If you have an idea, think about it, go for it. Just don't go get into entrepreneurship just to, you know, because it's sometimes a fad that you want to be an entrepreneur because it looks cool. But don't do it for that. But if you've got the right idea, if you've got the right passion to do it, if you've got the resources to do it, just do it.
Okay, thank you. Very well said, sir. So though we have lots of questions coming up, but we'll just restrict to one or two more because our students are really very excited to know who's the winner of the competition.
Sure.
The next question is something related to what you just spoke about. The student wants to know that Boat is mostly based on audio and music system, but with severe competition in the segment, how the company will boost or encash the upcoming opportunities?
So that's exactly what, you know, the reason I wanted to show you the presentation, that, you know, we believe in a lot of our consumers, our boatheads are the ones who will keep us who will keep us buying boat because of the quality we promise, because of the Indianness we promise, because of the price point we give, and at that value driven Indian mindset. But, you know, if you keep your consumer at the core of what you do, if you focus on the right needs, the consumers keep changing, right? Today, a few years back, they used to buy wired products, then they bought wireless products, and now true wireless is the next big thing. So the consumer is evolving, and if you don't evolve with them, you know, they will buy something else. So you keep evolving with them, give them the right products, and keep them happy. पहले नहीं बोलते थे ग्राहक भगवान होता है. You know, keep that in mind. You know, whatever said and done, that is actually true. Your consumer is your king. So make sure that you keep him happy.
I think very well said. Our young entrepreneurs have to learn that this is the world of consumers and they have to understand their needs well. Okay, so the next and the last question would be, technology market is not well developed in India as most of the import is done from China. With the government putting several restrictions on Chinese products, what are the opportunities for boat products in the coming months?
That's a very good question, and that is what is happening in India. You know that you as an entrepreneur don't fight races individually. There are so many challenges which will come up to your to where you are. Sometimes the consumer is changing, then your competition is changing, then the market landscape is changing. And you know, we used to study geopolitical reasons can also be a big part of business changes, right? Now today we all, this industry was dependent on China, and thankfully that, you know, Indian brands today have a better position than any other Chinese or global brand, because you know today we can change the way the world. You know, I remember the speech Mr. Modi said that, you know, why can't an Indian brand go outside and sell and dominate the world? And we are today positioned to do that, right? The whole world is looking beyond China, and you know, we are at the right place. In fact, last week we launched, if you go to our Insta page, Facebook page, it's all over the press. We launched our power banks, which were made in India by an Indian brand. It was not made in China by a Chinese brand or India by a Chinese brand. So we made that indigenous product. Our, you know, in a few months, we'll move most of our products to India. So I think it's the time to change. As I always say, keep changing. Market will make you change. Now, this the government is doing an outstanding effort to see that manufacturing comes back to India. And if it comes back to India, it becomes logical, then businesses like us will easily shift to India.
Well, indeed, as you said, change is the way of life. Thank you so much for sharing such practical piece of information with our students. Now, I would like to request our panelists to share their experience and feedback of the business ideas that our talented students have crafted and presented. Over to you, the panelists.
Thank you, Ms. Garima. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Raman for his insightful speech. I mean, the lecture or whatever we say, it was such a motivational speech for our students. They must have geared up for the entrepreneurship challenges and must have understood the importance of how to take up those challenges and how to cope with them, how to find opportunities in these challenges. Thank you so much. Next, for the students, you must have already been, like in the first session also, we talked a lot about entrepreneurship and about research. Now, at ABS, the Entrepreneurship Development and Incubation Center has been established specifically with the objective of developing the entrepreneurial mindset in the students. And here we not only, you know, develop this thing theoretically with you, rather we actually take up a lot of exercises with the students to develop them into entrepreneurs, to change that mindset of job seeking and becoming the job creators. We start with the creativity workshops, with the achievement motivation trainings, all the type of challenges, like we start with a 50 rupee challenge, perhaps as a club activity in the Seed Club, and then we move on to the bigger business plan competitions, where, and before that you are provided with a training on the design thinking, on the business canvas model and everything, so that you can actually plan your startup, you can actually plan your business idea in a very practical manner, with all feasibility things to be taken care of, the financial feasibility, the technical feasibility, the market research, all these are very important aspects of entrepreneurship, which your professors will be guiding you in the Entrepreneurship Development and Incubation Center here. So I welcome you all to ABS and I welcome you all to the EDIC. And I heartily congratulate you all for appearing, for giving your best in the Young Asian Entrepreneurship Challenge. And I would request Professor Vinod to elaborate on the challenge.
Yes, good afternoon, everybody. Well, it was really a tough task for us. I mean, for the panelists. Because last month, we went through near about more than 100 presentations from your side. And tough task because of the fact that over a period of time, we have to, it was very difficult for us to actually get people. I mean, these are the finalists. Why? Because of the fact that there were quite a few presentations that were really excellent. I mean, many of the presentations were so good that, if probably I believe that over the next couple of years, when the students will be probably molded by Asian Business School and they shall be fine-tuned as far as the marketing plan is concerned, as far as the financial planning is concerned, and all the other parameters, they shall be able to develop